Hey guys, it's me, Sam. I'm really in a weird start, apart from, do I feel like a bit of a numpty right now? Yes. Yes, I do. Most of you will probably have watched my big announcement video, where I announced I've got a job. Well, this video is going to explain how, today, I turned that job down. Most of you are going to probably think, you did what? After spending how long looking for work? I have my reasons, which I am going to explain. But first reason is the hours. I didn't realise that it was only for 25 hours a week. Now, after working out the wages I'd get each month, I literally would be £2.11 better off than what I'm on Job Seekers. Only out of my wages, I would also have to pay a large amount towards my rent and a large amount towards my council tax. I would basically lose my housing benefits and council tax benefits. After working out a bit more, I worked out I would probably have about £67 a week to live on. On Job Seekers, I get 75. I'm a bit miffed, not only with myself, but with our damn government. They said that they would do everything to help people get a job, get back into work, this, that, the other. But if you ask me, it's like they're purposely keeping people on the dole. I hate being on the dole. I'm still looking for work. I'm still sending my CV off to people. I've still had replies. Hopefully I might get some more interviews next week. Okay, my second reason for not taking the job was they lied to me. I received my contract through the post this morning after going through it. There's a few discrepancies that I had. First discrepancy I had was that they expect you to work for 5 hours side without a break. Now, I know that even if you do 4 hours, you're entitled to a 15-minute break. And I learned that from when I worked at Aldi. I even asked the other elf, is this correct? And he was like, yeah, 5 hours without a break. Not only that, they have a no-smoking policy. Now, I can understand that, but you're not even allowed to even smoke anywhere near the vicinity of the place. Another thing I wasn't happy about when I was going through their guidebook was the fact that you're not allowed to eat while you're at work. Well, if they expect you to sit there for 5 hours without a fag and nothing to eat in that time, I'm sorry, if I'd gone to work there, there would have been a riot. Simple as that. However, I rang them up this morning and I spoke to Mr. Butler, who was the chap who interviewed me, and I apologised and explained, I'm really sorry, I'm declining the offer. And he was really, really nice about it. I wasn't expecting it. I have to admit, guys, I was cacking my pants before I rung them. I mean, proper khaki in my pants. But no, he was really, really nice about it. He said, if I change my mind or circumstances change, you've got my number. So if you ever want to come back or start again, give me a ring. I was like, oh, bless him. Very, very nice. So at least I haven't burnt my bridges with them. So this means you guys are stuck with me for a little bit longer. I suppose in a way it's a good thing, but in a way it's a bad thing because I'm still on the dole. I'm really annoyed with myself because it was like, I got a job. But economically, it just wouldn't have worked out. Oh well, better luck next time, eh guys? It's taught me a lesson. I've learnt this much. I need to be doing at least 30 hours or more. But our government sucks and they really need to sort things out because they are really doing the working class families over. Anyway, enough of that. Please do forgive me for my numptiness. And I shall be back tomorrow with a, I don't know what, something. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please let me know your thoughts. Even if you want to tell me off, do so. I deserve it. But I'm going. You take care. Bye.